What's gone?
Yeah. No. I can't do cocktails. I was just saying that somebody can do cocktails.
What is the book you have?
This is the Hindi
one day.
I haven't seen it. Yeah,
गुरुदेव कृपा करके मुझको अपना लेना
गुरुदेव कृपा करके मुझको अपना लेना चरणों में जगा देना
चरणों में जगा देना
चरणों में जगा देना
गुरुदेव कृपा करके मुझको अपना देना
Thank you.
चार ऐसे बना वो पांच है
इंग्लिश पेज नंबर
49 देवा
Sri Ananda Sankirtan
Who do you want to sing? You want to sing something?
उसी में थोड़ा सा क्या क्या खाने का आइटम होता है
पापड़ा
पापड़ा सब डाल देना
कृष्ण देव Would you sing Kabi Habi first, and then I'll sing Krishna Devan.
Oh,
yeah, we have to sing Sudha Bhakta.
Okay, she sings Sudha Bhakta really nice. Bhakta.
Oh, yeah,
Thank you. 52. Is that what you're saying? Just there?
Krishna Deva Bhavantam
Krishna Deva Bhavantam
Krishna Deva Bhavantam
Krishna Deva Bhavantam
Madhasumadha Kadamra Prayanita Pada Mungata
I'm
Bye.
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Jai Om Nichilil Pravishtaram Vishnu Pad Paramahamsa Parivrajika Charya Sattasa Shishima Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai Jai Om Nichilil Pravishtaram Vishnu Pad Paramahamsa Parivrajika Charya Sattasa Shishima Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kesha Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai Jai Om Nichilil Pravishtaram Vishnu Pad Paramahamsa Parivrajika Charya Sattasa Shishima Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kesha Goswami Maharaj Ki Jai
Jyotsna Thakse Shishuman Sri Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada Ki Jai Jai Sri Vibhnu Guru Vagrini Ki Jai Prem Sakho Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadaraha Sri Vasari Sri Gaura Bhakti Vrinda Ki Jai Sri Andarib Maha Po Sri Mantarib Kudrum Dweep Madhrib Kala Dweep Vrita Dweep Janarib Madhrib Dweep Madhrib Dweep Madhrib Dweep Madhrib Dweep Madhrib Dweep Dham Ki Jai Sri Sri Radha Krishna Go Pagu Pagu Go Go Vedan Dwarasa Vananda Kashi Prajmandal Ki Jai Sri Dora Subhavani Ki Jai Sri Sham Kun Radha Kun Chimuna Ganga Tulsi Bhakti Devi Ki Jai Sri Jagannath Baladev Sabadju Ki Jai Akamaraj Sri Chaitanya Mat Ki Jai Sri Giraj Govran Gauri Mat Ki Jai Sri Keshav Ji Gauri Mat Ki Jai Vancouver Ki Jai Jai Gauri Premanandi Vancouver Gauri Mat
ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः आविर्भूतौ सकारुणौ शिवामनोनारायणौ रूपानुग प्रवरौद श्री केशव प्रिय भजे वंशा कल्पतरुभ्य कृपा सिंधु भये वच पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिसे नमः कनक जलद गात्रौ नीलसनाब्ज नेत्रौ मृगमद भर भालौ मालती कुंद मालौ तरल तरुण वेशौ नील पीतांबरेशौ स्मरणीभूत निकुंजे राधिका कृष्ण चंद्रौ हा देवी काकु भरदद गदयाद वाचा याचे निपत्त भूवि दंडवतौ भटार्ती अस प्रसादम बुधस्य जनस्य कृत्वा गंधर्विके निजगने गणनां विधेहि अंग समलिम छटा विरवित मंदी कृतेंदी वरम जगदन जागुडरोचि संग विदधतम पट्टंबर सिया वृंदारण्य निवासिनम विदलस धामाभिरामोदरम राधा स्कंद निवेशित जलभुजम धैयम दामोदरम भक्ता विहीनाय पराध लक्ष्य चित्वाश्च कामादि तरंग मध्ये कृपामयि त्वं शरणं प्रपन्ना वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदम वृंदे नमस्ते चरणारविंदम हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
First of all, I pay my humble obeisances under the lotus feet of my Paramaradha Guru Pad Padma, Om Vishnu Pad, Paramahansa Swami, Ashtotara Sata, Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj, and Om Vishnu Pad, Paramahansa Swami, Ashtotara Sata, Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj. I pay my obeisances under the lotus feet of my spiritual grandsire, Nityalila Prashtam Vishnupad Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj and Nityalila Prashtam Vishnupad Srila Bhakti Pradhan Keshav Goswami Maharaj. I pay my obeisances to all Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis assembled here. Today's Ekadasi. Discussing about anything about Ekadasi, I request Sripad Gyansikti Prabhu to speak something, any subject, or glory of Gurudev in 5 minutes.
Hare Krishna, नमः ओम विष्णु पदाय राधिकाय प्रथमने शिशिमाद His mercy seemed to hit us like a wave around death in the year 2000. Seemed to sweep the area around Vancouver, an area like a tsunami in a sense that it changed many of our lives forever. It would have been the same. Spiritual life seems to be like that. It seems to come in installments or waves. Poignant moments in our lives. I remember in my own life when I was very young, 1971, I believe it was, I was 10 years old, and I had had an experience with some Christians who had taught me that one should surrender to God out of fear, lest you burn in hell forever. And I just had that experience in my life at one point or another, hearing that kind of philosophy, and it seemed that God was a very fearful thing, a fearful entity. Didn't seem to be all that attractive. But then somehow, by the grace of Srila Prabhupada, I met some devotees in Calgary. I was very young, and I was told that if you want to know anything about God, to ask them. So I asked one devotee, and asked him, what is God about? And he described a very attractive, loving environment where one plays with God in different ways. And he spoke elaborately about this, and it suddenly it warmed my heart and gave me such encouragement that God is actually someone to be drawn towards rather than to be feared. So this set the tone for the rest of my life in appreciation of what God wants to be. And I received a stick of strawberry incense, which was wonderful. Never heard of such a thing. And I never forgot that. So fast forward about 10 years later, I was living in a teepee on Salt Spring Island, experimenting with hallucinogenic substances and trying to understand what my life was about and what the universe was, and came to the conclusion that if I was ever going to understand who God is or what God is, be it a he, she, or a thing, that I'd have to simply just surrender to what direction I was supposed to go. So, armed with that mood, I left the mountain and the teepee I was living in and went out into the world, and I planned to travel the world in search of who God would be. Less than 48 hours later, I found myself at the temple here in Vancouver, the ISKCON Temple. And the world was still reverberating from the wave that Srila Prabhupada sent around the world during the 12 years that he traveled the world and spread the holy name around the world. And that momentum was still active in the ISKCON Temple at the time. And I found the answers to all my questions and decided to surrender my life to try and become a devotee. But over the years, as the momentum, just like when one pulls the plug out of a fan, the fan, when Srila Prabhupada disappeared, there was still much momentum, but gradually the fan slowed down, and different things started to happen, and things were fragmenting, and I became weaker in my Krishna consciousness. Many of us felt that way. We looked around and saw difficulties coming from sources of shelter that we thought were worthy. And we gradually became more and more disillusioned, and I was certainly one of them. And then, when Srila Gurudev came in 1996, I had the fortune to hear his class at Charanagati, where I was living. And then in 2000, Srila Gurudev came again, and there was a larger wave of energy that was sweeping the community, and many devotees who wanted to take shelter of Gurudev. At that time, I decided to take Harinam from him, and he accepted me for his unlimited kindness. At Prasasya Prabhu's house, I had darshan with Srila Gurudev. He gave me the holy name, and he asked me if I had any questions. And I was thinking, I had many questions before I went in, but I didn't really have any at that moment. I was thinking in the back of my mind that there was some idea, some doubt. I was thinking maybe Gurudev he has some idea that he wants to create a new society, you know, like another society, and separate like from ISKCON, but another society. And I had some doubt about this, but I didn't think it was necessary to express. It was something I could think through. And I'm sure Gurudev, he looked down and he looked at me and he said, without my asking, he said, "I have not come to create any new society." Mm-hmm. Yeah. He said, I have come to promote the eternal society of Vrindavan. And at that point, I realized that through my spiritual master, the spiritual world can be revealed. And all around, I saw devotees becoming encouraged and hopeful and fearless. And all of us were experiencing that when we picked up Srila Prabhupada's books again, we were reading them again, we read them with new insight and new dimension that we had never thought possible. Time and time again, you can see this. When Srila Gurudev came in 2008, he spoke in two different places, one in Surrey and one in Richmond, and many devotees came, devotees that were, the continuing wave was sweeping the world, and many, many more devotees were coming, and that continues to this day. Just to beg that I can stay within the association of devotees and be worthy of the gifts that you're given and given and continue to grow in the association.
Thank you. Guru Gurugunath Prabhu, why you invite us in Vancouver?
I have been a practicing devotee for many years. And throughout those years, I was always feeling some weakness. And when I had the opportunity to associate with Srila Gurudev, weakness that I was feeling had gone away. So I said to Srila Gurudev that I expressed that I was feeling so much strength. And Srila Gurudev said to me that the reason that I was feeling weak is because those who I was associating with did not have the power. I did not have the power. And I said to Srila Gurudev at that time that I was drowning. And I said that Vrajnath Prabhu had seen me drowning and he came and saved me and pulled me under his lotus feet. Srila Gurudev's lotus feet, yes. And we were in Mauritius at the time, right on the ocean side. And Gurudev said to me, "You were drowning?" Like this. And I said, "Not in this ocean here, in the ocean of material existence." And I said that Vrajnath Prabhu had pulled me under his lotus feet. And I was feeling very happy. And Gurudev told me that Vrajnath Prabhu and Madh Maharaj, he said, they're serving 24 hours. He said, they are asking me for bhakti, so I must give. He said, so I had the the great fortune of meeting some devotees of Gurudev, some very close associates of Gurudev, and they gave me an opportunity for service. Otherwise, I would have no chance of massaging Gurudev's feet, massaging his back and hands. Without getting that association, there'd be no opportunity for service. And one day also I went to Brajnath Prabhu and I said, is there any service that I can do? If you can please help me find some service that I can observe myself in. So within minutes, it seems, that he told me, well, Madhav Maharaj is writing a book, maybe you can help with that. Next thing you know, I was doing some editing and I had some papers in front of me. We were upstairs, Gurudev came up and was talking to somebody on the computer. Somebody, I guess he was giving initiation or something. President Gurudev brought him upstairs because the reception was better upstairs. And when he came out of the room, I was working on a paper and there was many marks on the paper with little corrections in a red pen. And Gurudev asked me, and he said, are you doing this? These corrections? And he said, yes, sure, Gurudev. And he said, very good. And he put his hand on the head. Very good. So, by that I could understand that that service I got from Gurudev's devotees, and he said it was very good that I was doing that service. So Madhav Maharaj was asking me why I invited them. Because my only connection with Gurudev is through his intimate disciples, through his intimate servants. And this is why I invited them, because this is how we get the mercy of the Guru, is by becoming the servant of the servant of the servant. This is our constitutional position. So we should all try and take advantage. And especially we can see that when Madhav Maharaj speaks or Bhagavan Prabhu speaks, that actually Gurudev is speaking through them. Everything they've heard is from Gurudev. They understand Gurudev's mood, they understand how Gurudev handles different situations, and they know what Gurudev wants, and they're doing that. So this is why we want to get their association and have them come again and again.
Thank you. So today is Ekadasi.
Ekadasi sabda came from Ekadas. This is Sanskrit word. Ekadas means 11. We have 11 senses. 5 senses are acquiring knowledge, like eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. These are called Ganendriya, to acquiring knowledge. And 5 active senses by which we do some action, like speech, feet, hand, and 2 in the lower section. And top of them, mind is called king of senses. If mind is not there, he could not function properly. You are sitting here in class, but mind not here, then you could not understand or keep it your heart properly. So everywhere mind must be involved. So mind everywhere involving, so he became king and controlling all senses. So mind is the king of all senses. In Ekadasi, Srila Gurudev has told that, and is mentioned in scripture also, in Ekadasi, have to control all your senses and have to engage them in the service of Hari, Guru, and Vaishnava. and the rule of and how to maintain ekadasi mention ekadasi upasa nirambu bhaksha have to be full fasting even water but in kali yug not possible for everyone very few can do this in other yugas ekadasi also there but other yugas they used to do full fast in satya yug treta yug and dapar yug before kali was dapar in dapar yug all is to maintain ekadasi even the five pandavas bhim also maintain ekadasi bhim used to tell krishna oh without eating I could not maintain my life I am not able to do full fasting you have to give some concession for me then okay you can maintain ekadasi you can take some roots fruits but one ekadasi you have to do full fasting that called pandava nirjala ekadasi in hot summer time seven bhim also is to do full fasting once but others pandavas they is to do full fasting and in dapar yug even maharaj nanda the father of brajanandan samsundar krishna and mother jasoda all brajavasis is to do ekadasi that is the proof once nanda baba after ekadasi went to take bath in the yamuna according to vedic tradition before brahma muhurta no one enter allowed to either pond or any river or any ocean this is called asuri kal not allowed to go there so nanda baba could not understand the desire of krishna Nanda went to Yamuna. He took a dip after that not coming out. Nanda was some servants was with you, with him. They are searching, where Nanda was, they could not find. They became very upset. They came back and informing Krishna, your father went to take bath, never coming out. All Brajavasis became very scared because his skin is not there. Then some chaos will be there. Krishna said, okay. Krishna took his Nanda Baba's servant and came to Yamuna. And he told, I am going to search my father. Don't worry. And Krishna understood what happened. He took one deep and went to Varun Lok. Varun is the predominating deity of water. Either ocean or pond or river. Is a pure entity of water. Nanda went direct to, Krishna went direct to Varun, abode of Varun. Because Varun's messenger, they captured Nanda Baba and took him to Varun Lok. Why? Because he came odd time. And Varun sent his messenger, why? Well, if I bring Nanda Baba, then Krishna bound to come, take him back from here. Then by this excuse, I can take the son of Sri Krishna. He has not desired to harass Nanda Baba or punish him. He has cherished desire to take darshan of Krishna in his own abode. He can come to darshan Krishna in Braj. He has desire to take Krishna's darshan, his own abode. So, Krishna bound to come. And he respects Nanda Baba so nicely. When Krishna came, then all the messengers of Varun, who lives in the Varun, abode of Varun, all came and they respect Krishna. Then they worshiping Krishna's feet, doing arati, giving so many presentations. Nanda became very happy. Oh, they are honoring my son so much. Why so? Must be some extra quality in my son. I know that. Wherever danger, he takes the whole Braj out from the danger. Look, they also knew these things, so they are honoring my son. Nanda Baba never think that Krishna is Bhagavan. That is my loving son. After that, Varun Dev, with so many presentation, with Nanda Baba and Krishna, sent back to Braj. So this is proof here that Nanda Baba and Jasoda Maiya, all Brajavasis, to maintain ekadasi. now coming again in Kali Yuga. When Prem Purushottam, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu incarnated in this world, in especially in Bengal and other places, it is mentioned that only widows or saintly person will maintain Ekadasi, not married lady. So Mahaprabhu thought that although I am Krishna, I incarnate in this world taking the mood of devotee, and I have to teach how to do bhakti, what is his process. If I not practice myself and not teach others, people will not understand. So first one day he told her small boy, "Mother, can you give me one benediction please?" "Yes, why not? You will not take any grain in the day of Ekadasi." Mother said, "Yes, no problem." And Mother Sochi, Jagannath Mishra, all are maintaining Ekadasi. And not only that, all the inhabitant of Navadvip days to maintain Ekadasi, observe Ekadasi. When the Mahaprabhu was a small boy, if anyone tell Haribol, Haribol, Hare Krishna and Dukirtan, Mahaprabhu stop his weeping. One day, a small boy, weeping so bitterly, so many came from neighbors, they are clapping and chanting Hare Krishna, Haribol, so many Kirtan. Today, non-stop Mahaprabhu weeping. We want to take him lap, Mahaprabhu kicking his hand and feet, coming out from lap. Mother said, "Oh my dear son, why are you weeping so bitterly? What happened?" Caressing him, loving him, "Oh Baba Nimai, oh my dear son, please tell what happened, what do you want?" Then Mahaprabhu replied, "Baby Nimai, that in our village, name is Jagadish, he prepared so many preparations for the Thakurji and offered the Thakurji, I want that prasad, then I stop my weeping. So that day Ekadasi, so no rice, no grain. And what am I preaching here? That Mahaprabhu saying Bhagavan, the fasting or observing Ekadasi for devotee, for practitioner, for sadhak, not for Bhagavan. Even the householder devotee, they must have to offer some grain other to for Thakurji, for their deity, but they should not accept that thing, they will accept that prasad next day. So Mahaprabhu want to teach the whole world, you have to offer your deity, everything is normal, is to offering other day. So they went, they became surprised, how this baby Nimai knew, we prepare so many things for our Thakurji. Offering was going on. After offering, they give everything for baby Nimai. And he ate everything. He is showing that he is Bhagavan, have to offer everything for Bhagavan, not for sadhak. When Mahaprabhu grew enough, he meant observing Ekadasi, because he has to teach. By this he teach two things. One, you may do fast, either full fast or taking anukalpa, means like fruits, roots, and milk products, you are allowed to take, but no grain at all. So Mahaprabhu want to teach this, and other hand, teaching, then you have to offer grain, other thing, like other day, have to offer your deity. By this first time, Mahaprabhu taught two things the whole world in Kali Yuga.
So some teaching that he was Bhagavan?
Yes. By this he is showing that I am Bhagavan, otherwise how you can eat this? As before, Mahaprabhu also taking what Mother Sachimaya and Jagannath is offering, he is taking, but he wants to show this, but people understand that he teaching is saying Bhagavan due to his influence of Jogmaya. It will come later. So after that, Mahaprabhu growing up, and after renounce order, Mahaprabhu went to Jagannath Puri Dham. 24 years he was in household life, and last 24 years he was in Jagannath Puri. First some South India for preaching, after that last 18 years he spent only Jagannath Puri. Among 18 years, 6 years he did Ratha Yatra, and meeting with devotees. Last 12 years, always feeling separation in the mood of Radhika for Krishna. When Mahaprabhu was Jagannath Puri, in Jagannath Puri, they thought that he had no need to do any Ekadasi. When he go in, new person will go, the Pandas will tell that in Jagannath Puri Ekadasi is hanging upside down. Means no need to Ekadasi. They try sewing, they tie rope with Ekadasi's feet and upside down. Why? In Jagannath Devi, Supreme Personality Godhead, he will take everything, rice, dal, no problem. But devotee must have to observe Ekadasi, otherwise bhakti will ruin. So one day, the Pandas thought that influence of Mahaprabhu so much, thousands and thousands devotees coming every year. So if you captured him, and if he told that no need to maintain Ekadasi, then no one will do Ekadasi in Jagannath Puri. Then our prasad will sell very nicely. So one day, when Mahaprabhu was with so many devotees, the Pandas brought so many type of preparation of prasad, and they kept in front of Mahaprabhu. Then what to do now? And it mentioned in scripture for Mahaprasad, Suskang Parju Sitang Bhapi Nitang Bhadura Desato Praptimatra Praktabvam Natrakala Vicharana. Even Mahaprasad became dry, became stale, not fresh, and even brought from so far distance, and never be impure. As soon as you get Mahaprasad, have to honor immediate. And Mahaprabhu knows all Siddhanta. That Pandas is thinking, what he will do? We will see what he will do. If he not take, then neglecting Mahaprasad is offense. If he take, then he will broke his Ekadasi. Now in a dilemma, what to do? But Mahaprabhu sang Bhagavan, Shastra Janitvat, all Shastra, all injunction of Shastra coming from his lotus feet. He could not do any wrong. And not only that, Yejan Krishna Bhaji Sevara Chatur, we were doing bhajan of Krishna, they're very, very tricky and very extremely clever. Even they can cheat Krishna and capture Krishna in their heart. They are not an ordinary person. So Mahaprabhu and associates are there. Then Mahaprabhu start glorifying Mahaprasad. With all devotee glorifying and doing parikrama Mahaprasad, whole day, whole night passed, glorifying, glorifying Mahaprasad. So many glorification in Mahaprasad, we can see Vyad Bhagavatamrita, more than any place. The glorification of Mahaprasad is described by Śrīla Sanātana Gosvāmī Pāda from different scripture in Vyad Bhagavatamritam. So when morning came, Mahaprabhu, let us go to ocean to take bath. Then ocean to took bath. After that, Mahaprabhu ordered all devotees, chanted Gayatri mantras. They did chant their Gayatri mantras. After that, all the honored Mahaprasad. So even Mahaprabhu being saying Bhagavan, he maintained Ekadasi. In his childhood he sowed one pastime, and in his after renounce order, the Jagannathri pastime he sowed also, is observing Ekadasi. And I told about Daparju, that Pandavas, they also maintain Ekadasi. Every here it mentioned. Now I am giving example, I am coming back, jumping from Kali Yuga to Satya Yuga. Because Satya Yuga first started in Akshaya Tritiya, it's coming 6th of May. In Satya Yuga, when creation was going on, all are very happy. So one day, Krishna was traveling and he heard some weeping coming from south direction. Why happened? Why so many people are weeping? Then Krishna went that side, understood people are coming who are in hellish planet. The south direction is hellish planet. North direction is the abode of Shivji. And here the personified death living in south direction. So seeing their unhappiness, hearing their weeping, their lamentation, Krishna became very unhappy. What to do? How I can deliver my living entity from this hellish planet? So Krishna became himself Ekadasi. And for Ekadasi mention, Ekadasi Tithi Bhakti Janani Jatane Palana Kari Krishna Basati Basati Bali Parama Adare Bari. Ekadasi is the root of all devotion. Like mother your child, Janani means who is giving birth of children. Like mother giving birth of children, in the same way who will observe Ekadasi, he can get bhakti in his heart. So you have to maintain Ekadasi very careful. What is prohibited, not to accept. What is favorable, have to accept that. And Krishna basati basati boli parama adare bori. We have to honor Ekadasi Tithi. Why? Krishna live in that very day. So he'll call Madhav Tithi or Ekadasi Tithi. So then Krishna became Ekadasi himself. Now gradually, the abode of Jam, Maharayam, now there is not so many prisoners anymore. Gradually became less and less. One day, Maharayam thought, what shall I do now? Better I can quit my job. Then they held a meeting. There is 12 Mahajanas. Mahajanas means greatly personalities. Swayambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kumaro, Kapilo, Manu, Prahlado, Janaka, Bhishma, Bolir, Vyasa, Ki, Vayam. That Swayambhu means Brahmaji, who never taken birth from mother's womb. Swayambhu came and found lotus nev of girl size navel. Swayambhu Narad Rishi. Each and every abode of Bhagavan, you can see Narad Rishi is there and serving Lord Krishna, Lord Ram, Lord Mahaprabhu, every all incarnation Narad Rishi is there. Then Swayambhu means Shivji. Swayambhu, Narada, Swayambhu, Kumar means four Kumars. Sanak, Sanandan, Sanatan, Sanat Kumar. Kopil means Kopil Dev. The Kopil Dev with the Sangbad in Bhagavatam, that Kopil. Kopil is two, one Nirishar Kopil and the Sessar Kopil. Sessar Kopil means the incarnation of Bhagavan. Saktave Sabata, that Kopil Muni. One Kopilo, Manu. Manu means who arranged Manu Sanghita. Kumaro Kopilo Muni, Prahlad. Maharaj Prahlad, the son of Hiranyakashipu, for whom Nrisimhadev appeared in this world to protect his bhakti and kill Hiranyakashipu, demon Hiranyakashipu. Prahlad Janak. Janak means the father of Sita Devi. This is that title. His name was not Janak. His name was Siraddha Janak. Janak is the title, like president, prime minister. It's not name of anyone. It's post. Like Brahma, this is a post, not name. So, Janak Maharaj, the father of Sita Devi or father-in-law, Bhagavan Ram. Bhishma Pitamaha, he has boon from his fathers. Wherever he want, he can die, none can kill him. Death under his control. Why? Because Bhishma Pitamaha, when he was a young boy, then his father went some places and saw an extremely beautiful girl and became attracted towards him, towards her. And he's coming, going every day, became very unhappy. And he told his ministers, I want to marry that girl, but my son grew enough. What can I do? Then Bhishma Pita's name at that time was Devabrata. He approached the father of that girl. That girl was not his own father. That girl not his own daughter. He nourished that girl. He told, no problem, but I have one condition. What? Whose son will come from my daughter soon, he will be king. So he could not agree. Coming every day and going. And Bhishma Pitama, Devabrata, notice his crown prince, notice why my father so disminded, always unhappy. I never see, few days I am seeing this. He asks his father, father don't know nothing, don't worry. Then he asks his minister, can you ask my father what is mystery behind this? Maybe I am his son, he could not open his heart to me. He may disclose his heart to you, because you are his minister long time. We are same age, like my father's friend. Minister knows everything. Okay, I will try at my level best. Then minister told, this is the fact. So, what shall I do now? One day, Bhishma Pitama told this minister, he can watch where father is going. He needs to go there, sit some time and coming back. Okay. Next day, Devabrata went to that boatman's house and told, why you are not marrying your daughter to my father? Then he told, I want, who will be my grandson, he will be king of this kingdom. But you are very qualified, so you will be king, I know that. So I don't want to give my daughter to your father. Then he did promise, my whole life I will not marry and I will not be king. Then all demigods saw power, oh, no one like you. So from that his name became Bhishma. Very strong vow he has taken. So all became very happy, then marriage took place. So is Bhishma also one of 12 Mahajan? Prahlado Janaka Bhishma Boli, Maharaj Boli, who did Atma Nivedan for Vamandev. And Vayamini Maharaj Iyam. Then Brahma told, don't worry, I'll arrange something. One day Brahma, because Brahma is the pure deity of creation, he created one extremely beautiful girl. And when girl appeared, told, oh my dear father, why you create me? What is your desire? How I can serve you? How I can fulfill your all desires? Brahmaji, and what is my name? Brahma told, Mohini. Mohini means who can bewilder everyone. Well, who will see you? They'll bewilder towards your beauty. So your name will be Mohini. What is my duty? Then Brahma is telling, you have to go material world. There is one king, name is Dharmangad. Dharma means religion, Anga means limbs of the body. His all body full of religion. And he has one wife, one son, son name is Rukmangad. Rukma means gold, Anga means body. His whole body full of gold, golden ornament. And his rule was there, that whoever live in his kingdom, everybody have to observe Ekadasi. Who will not follow, can kick him out from his kingdom. And the one condition, have to follow Ekadasi. So day before Ekadasi, the rule is that the 10th day of moon have to take prasad once a day, not twice or thrice. And Ekadasi day full fasting. And next day have to do paran, only one time prasad. This is the rule. So king, before Ekadasi day in morning, he'll announce everywhere. At that time, not like electronics media, the king, they'll send their servants, they'll go to Tree Junction or her four road meeting, they'll beat some drums. Hearing drum sound, all will come. They'll announce tomorrow is Ekadasi. Everybody have to follow Ekadasi. Will not maintain Ekadasi, will be kicked out from Dharmangad's kingdom. So everywhere they are doing. Then Brahma told, he is doing like this. And now he make his son Rukmangad as a crown prince and putting him in the old throne, he went to forest for doing bhajan. He had to deviate from his religion. When he told, oh, this is very insignificant for me. I'll buy by side long glance, I'll finish my job. This is very easy for me. Baba said, no, this is not so easy. It's very strong personality. Be very careful. And according to Vedic tradition, it's mentioned Panchasodhang Banang Brajet. When you're over 50, you have to do your bhajan. Either you can do bhajan with your wife, or you can go alone to do bhajan. And have to give all responsibility to your children. In Satya Yuga, it was very easy. Forest, there is so many places to stay, so many fruits, roots, and nowadays there is no place in forest. Almost forest is finished from all over the world, there is no fruits at all. So if you be in household life, have to detach from household life. You have to do like you as a duty, not so much attached. So he gave all responsibility to his children Rukmanga, then went to forest for doing bhajan. His wife wanted to go with him. He told no, because children, no one is there. Who will be his guardian? You have to guide him. You have to stay here, no problem. So he is doing bhajan in being in forest. That Mohini went there. King is doing bhajan, his eyes is closed. And Mohini sitting very close to him and making so many posture. When king opened his eyes, so very nice, beautiful lady. I never seen so beautiful in my whole life. Who is she? Why she came here? Better let me talk with her. Then king came to her and told, oh my dear lady, what is your name? Where you live? Why you come to this forest? How I can help you? Then lady told, my name is Mohini. Oh, very nice name, Mohini. Where you live? He told, I am daughter of Brahmaji. Why you came in this forest? Then she told, I am searching for my qualified bridegroom. And I am so young, so beautiful. And you are also beautiful, very young. I think you will be my fittest bridegroom for me. Then king told, okay, no problem. But I gave up my kingdom. Now my son became king. But I think if I marry you, my son will not oppose and they will welcome me very well. My son is very obedient and very loyal. Okay, then let us go to your kingdom. Then taking Mohini, the king Dharmanga is coming back to his kingdom. And he sent someone as before that I am coming back. So first queen of the king Dharmangad and his son Rukmangad, both of them came in the border and welcomed both of them with so many Brahmins and like band, and they bring horse, elephant, welcome very nicely. Now king married with the new wife. Now king became king Dharmangad and queen became Mohini. Although first queen was very gentle, very beautiful, and very religious, but she told her son, oh my dear son, your father likes her so much, so be obedient towards your stepmother, and I will treat her like my own sister. They are doing so. And now, day for Ekadasi, they are beating drum and announcing. And Mohini told, oh king, what is going on there? Why that beating drum? What they are announcing? Then king told, tomorrow is Ekadasi. So everybody have to observe Ekadasi. And if not, they have to kicked out from my kingdom. From 8 years to 8 years, everybody have to observe Ekadasi. What? What is Ekadasi? I don't like Ekadasi, Ekadasi. Then king explained how to observe Ekadasi. Today have to take prasad once time, tomorrow full fast, next day one time. I will not do Ekadasi, Ekadasi. I don't like all this nonsense thing. What is this? And she knows everything. So prior to that, one day before, he called some scholarly Brahmin and told, she called some Brahmins and told that I'll call you tomorrow. So you have to tell, no, the king will not maintain ekadasi and married lady will not do ekadasi. If king will do observe ekadasi, then without taking grain he will be weak. If any other king invade his kingdom, then he will got defeat. So king not allowed. Only brahman will do, no kshatriya and no married lady. Only saintly person and widow will do this. Brahmin, they get lot of money, got lot of golden coin. King told, no, must have to do ekadasi, otherwise they'll kick out from my kingdom. I will not do ekadasi. King told, no problem, I'll kick you out also. But do you think I control by your lust? Don't think so. Because you are alone in the forest, let you never be alone. It mentioned in scripture, Pita rakshati kaumare, bharta rakshati jauvane, putrastu sthavire bhave, nati satantra marati. When he says girl, then father and mother, especially father will take care. And when married, then bharta rakshati jauvane, husband will take care and maintain her, his wife. When she became very old, then children will take care. So king told, you are alone there, so I brought you here. Do you think I control by you? I control by my religion, by ekadasi, by my devotion, not by you. If you don't maintain ekadasi, I'll kick you out from my kingdom. What do you think? Then Mohini became scared. Then he remembered that Brahma told, he is not an ordinary personality, very strong personality, be careful. Next thing, what to do now? Then first queen of king came, told, oh my dear sister, don't be upset. You do or not let king maintain ekadasi. Mohini told, no, my husband not allowed to also observe ekadasi. Because if king observe ekadasi, then he will be weak. If other king knew this thing, he invade our kingdom, we will lose our everything. Only the rule, kshatriya will not maintain ekadasi, only the brahmins and saintly person and widow, they will maintain ekadasi. This is the injunction of scripture. All become surprised. Okay, call some brahmin who knows scripture. They invite brahmin. Brahmin told, Mohini is telling true. Kshatriya, especially king, not allowed to observe ekadasi at all. And married lady will not do. Only widows, brahmins, mainly saintly person observe ekadasi. King became very angry with brahmins. I'll kick you out also from my kingdom. What do you think? And they know king is very strong. They're not telling so much thing. Then first queen told, oh my dear sister, let king observe ekadasi, you do or not, this is not a big deal. And Mohini told, okay. She became little angry, became lenient and told. Then first queen told again, oh my dear sister, if you observe ekadasi, exchange of that, what you want, you are ready to give everything for yourself. Let king also observe ekadasi or you both. Mohini told, I will not never maintain ekadasi, what may be. And I will not allow my husband also maintain ekadasi. Only one condition, you and your husband, both of you have to chop your son's head. And not only one chop, have to cut by saw. Saw means it gradually come and going. And not only that, neither you will weep, your husband will weep. And not only that, your son should not weep. Three of you should not weep, have to smiling, have to cut his head. How big, strange condition. How mother can tolerate this, have to cut her own son with saw and not allow to weep. Even son, when you are cutting anyone, in one chop you don't understand, have to cut by saw so many times coming, going, how painful. Son told, I have no problem. If my life, I can dedicate my life for ekadasi, my life will be successful. Hearing him, mother became very happy. Oh, this is my proper son. For ekadasi, he will dedicate his life. She told, I have no problem. King told, no. Mohini, get out from my kingdom. Somehow or other, the first queen specified king. Okay, then they be brought sir and start. As soon as put sir and want to start, immediate Brahmaji, Vishnu and Maheshwar appeared there. And Vishnu Bhagavan is telling, Varan Bruhi, Varan Bruhi, ask any benediction. Then King Dharmangal told, O Prabhu, if you are pleased, and Vishnu says, I am very pleased with you. If you are very pleased, then I want only one benediction. What? Don't take so hard test anymore in future. It's too much. How father and mother can cut their sunset even without weeping? I don't like you'll take test anymore in future for anyone. Vishnu began to smile, so be it. Then they took Dharmangad and his first queen, Vaikuntha planet, and Rukmangad became king. Now Mohini lamenting, what shall I do? Where shall I go? What is my destiny? Brahmaji told, because Vishnu took already to them. So Brahma told, oh my dear daughter, you have to be in this world. Whoever not maintain Ekadasi, you can get their result. And not only that, Mohini told, everybody is maintaining Ekadasi here. Then he told Brahmaji, Ekadasi two types, one is Vidha, one is Suddha. Vidha means when Ekadasi connected with 10th day, when Dasamiti with Ekadasi, it's called Vidha Ekadasi. If someone maintain Ekadasi Dasamiti, that result you will get and maintain your life. Vidha means mixed with Dasamiti. Even if there is mixed tithi in Ekadasi, and then have to maintain Ekadasi next day, not Vidha Ekadasi. So whoever maintaining Vidha Ekadasi, that result, they will not get any bhakti, that result will go to Mohini. So by this way, Mohini, maintaining Ekadasi, getting power and alive in this world. So, we have to maintain Ekadasi from age of 8 to 80. After 80, if someone maintain Ekadasi or not, no problem. When Gurudev in advanced age, after he take his medicine, I told Gurudev, now you are over 80, you have no need to observe Ekadasi anymore. Gurudev told, this is true, this supported by scripture, but if I not observe Ekadasi, so many so-called disciples will come, oh, my Gurudev never observe Ekadasi, because they will come in last time, they will not see what I am doing, so much austerity, they will not know, oh, my Gurudev is not doing, so I will not do. They will not think what I had done as before, and I am doing everything according to Vedic scripture, they will understand this. They are not qualified, and they will tell, no, our Gurudev never did, or will not do. So I have to, unless until, I mean, not unconscious, I must maintain Ekadasi. Otherwise, not only disciples, some devotee will tell, our Gurudev is not, he is not maintaining Ekadasi, why I will do? So how long I will alive in this world? I must maintain Ekadasi. So Gurudev used to do also. I am giving another incident of Satyayug. In Satyayug, you know about Ambarish Maharaj. Ambarish Maharaj, he was king of whole world. And being king, in this world we have so much wealth, then we make so many, keep so many servants. In India, population so much, you can see with wealthy person, they have 2-3 servants. Especially in Asia, India, and other places also. So, being the emperor of whole world, Ambarish, what he used to do? He used to clean temple by his own hand, grooming, cleaning, and he engaged his ministers and Brahmins to maintain the kingdom. And he doing by himself all pious activity by his own hand. Mano Krishna Padaro Bindayo, by mind is always thinking, meditating about Krishna's lotus feet. And Bachansi Gunanu Varnane, He is using speech to glorify Krishna, his roop, his beauty, his form, his quality and pastime and his associates. And by feet he is doing parikrama of holy places. By ear he is hearing Harikatha. By nose he is taking smell fragrant of sandal pulp and tulasi offered to lotus feet of Bhagavan. He engaged all senses for the serving of Krishna. And his rule was to maintain Ekadasi, all Ekadasi. At the time all are observing Ekadasi. Bhagavan creates some time to time as a critical situation. By that he is showing the glory of his devotee. So one day after Ekadasi, our king is to maintain Ekadasi completely full fasting. We day for Ekadasi, one time prasad, Ekadasi full fasting, next day, one time prasad, Paramit Charanami, then one time prasad. So after Ekadasi day, he is about to do his paran. In the meantime, Durvasarisi appeared there and told, "Oh king, I am appeared here, came to your royal palace." King Bhishmaram, "Very good. So today you are my honorary guest. So you can take prasad here. Today is Dadasi. This is very good that any saintly person came take prasad here." Durvasa told, "I am going to take bath in Jamuna, I am coming back very soon." Durvasa knowingly making late, became delay. And king is thinking, "What shall I do now?" And he is Brahmarshi. So if I neglect him, he may curse me. I will die, my whole dynasty will finish, my kingdom will finish, will ruin. Other hand, if I not do paran on time, then my bhakti will finish. What shall I do? Now he is in a dilemma. If I not honor Durvasa Rishi, he will understand by his mystic power and he'll by curse finish me, my kingdom, my all subjects, my all dynasty, everything will finish. Other hand, if not do parana on time, then bhakti will go away. What shall I do? Then he called some Brahmins and Vaishnav. They told king, "Yes, it's a very critical situation. And very decision is very fragile, very delicate." Then discussing scripture, they told that you did full fast. If you take Charanamrit, is as well as equal to taking or not taking both. By this, you can maintain your Ekadasi paran and without feeding your guest, not eating anything. So you can take one drop Charanamrit, is equal to break your paran because you full fasting and is not eating also. All Brahmins told, "Okay, no problem." And king took only one drop Charanamrit because time is going to run out. And Durvasa knowingly making delay. As soon as he took Charanamrit, in the meantime, Durvasa came like became fire. "Oh king, do you know who am I? You are a householder, you think you have so much money, so you neglect your guest like myself. You know what can I do?" And then he took on matted lock from his head and dropped in the floor. As soon as he did that, one fiery demon appeared there. And Durvasa hints, "Go and finish this king." Fiery demon is coming, running towards King Ambarish. Ambarish Maharaj, "Jayon Krishna Bhaje Sebara Chatu and Bhukti Mukti Siddhi Kami Sakali Asanto Krishna Bhakta Niskam Atayir Santo." Bhukti, who want enjoy and who want salvation, they are always Asanto, means restless. And but Krishna devotee, very calm and quiet. They are not agitated by any condition. Swambharis Maharaj, very calm and quiet. It mentions in scripture that who is doing bhajan, if anything, they could not maintain properly. To maintain that, Bhagavan engaged 30 million Rishi Maharshi to complete that thing. It mentioned in Vyad Bhagavatamitam, quoted from scripture. Mat kriya kurvatan bhakta kriya lopa bhavet jodi. If anything not maintained properly, then he Bhagavan engaged Tishrakoti Maharshaya, engaged 30 million of Maharshi to complete that work. So Durvasa is very calm and quiet. Amarishma is calm and quiet. And Durvasa is very angry. As soon as Hariraman came very close to Ambarish Maharaj, Bhagavan Sudarshan Chakra was there ready. He killed fiery demon, finished there. And Bhagavan told, to protect of my devotee, I engage Sudarshan Chakra. Now Sudarshan Chakra chased to Durvasa. Ambarish, my heart became melt. Oh Prabhu, he is Brahmarshi, don't kill him. Please don't kill him. So, due to prayer of Ambarish Maharaj, Sudarshan Chakra, chasing him, not killing. If you want, in a second, less than a second, he can kill him. Due to prayer of Ambarish Maharaj, Sudarshan Chakra, not killing, chasing. Then Durvasa running, and looking behind time to time. Oh, he's very close, almost to grab. As much his speed, running. Then he went to Brahmaji. Oh Brahmaji, save me, trahimam. Brahma told Prabhu, I am sorry. I cannot help you. If I give you shelter, then Durvasa, what happened? Well, look, who is coming behind you? Before you, he will kill me and burn my whole abode and then to you. Because if someone is criminal, if you support him, then you are same guilty. Because if you accomplish any task and who help you to accomplish that task, both are same guilty. This is the philosophy of Mother Yashoda and this is philosophy of material world also. When Krishna stolen butter in Mother Yashoda's house and feeding crows and monkeys, when Mother Yashoda caught Krishna red-handed, he told, oh, this grinder mortar helps my Lala to steal butter. Both are same guilty. So I have to punish both. Same punishment, so bind both of them, same rope, grinder mortar and Krishna. So Brahmaji telling, if you do so, if you give you shelter, then Sudarshan Chakra burn me first, then to you. So I cannot give you shelter. What to do now? Durvasa told, better I can do go my father. He went to Shivlok. How Shivji became father of Durvasa Rishi? Yes. Small story. Once, Narad Rishi, you know about Narad Rishi? He always arranged some quarreling each other. And by that, they're increasing their devotion. So one day, Narad Rishi went to Vaikuntha planet and told Lakshmiji. And he's so clever, at that time Narayani was not there. Told, oh, Lakshmiji, you are thinking that you are the most chaste lady in the whole universe, all over Vaikuntha every year. It is not true at all. Then to, oh Narada, how are you telling this thing? Well, if you want to see the chaste best, have to go mortal world. Well, who is there? Narada, this is told, one lady is there named Anusuya Devi, wife of Atrishi. The chaste best in the whole universe, even non-equal to in Vaikuntha planet also. How come? In mortal world, somebody chase and me? Narada Rishi telling this, taking his violin. Simon Narayana, Narayana, Narayana. Simon Narayana, Narayana, Narayana. Smiling and left Vaikuntha planet. Then landed in Kailas. Shivji was not there, Parvati alone. Parvati told, oh Narada Thakur, how you came? How I can serve you? As you don't know, I don't need any service. I have to inform you something, so I was passing through. So it came in my mind, better to tell you. What you want to tell? What is the information? He told, you think that you are very chaste and Lakshmiji is not true at all. What? Lakshmiji is not chaste? Well, no. She is chaste, you are chaste also, no problem. I am not telling the unchaste lady, but if you see the best chaste, have to go mortal world. What? Mortal world chaste than me and than Lakshmi? Yes. So who is she? Then he told, Anusya Devi, wife of Atridisi. Then from there, walk out. Om Namah Shivaya, glorifying Shivji, went out. Then went to Brahmalok. Brahmaji not there, only Savitri Devi alone. And going as a time that they will not be present, knowingly doing this. So Narada went there and told Savitri Devi, oh Savitri Devi, what are you thinking? You have some proud that you are chest, best chest in the world, or no? I never think. Parvati Devi, especially Lakshmi Devi, chest in the whole universe and whole planet, even in Vaikuntha. Not at all. Why not? Then he told same story to Savitri Devi and walk out from there. Now it's very.
What he was singing?
Hmm?
When he left there, what he was singing?
Singing about Narayan? No, for Narayan he's singing. Then went out. Now, what to do now? Then Lakshmi informed Parvati and Savitri and told her, yes, Narada came and told me same thing, told us. What to do now? Even Narada is not only making quarreling between Brahma, Savitri or Parvati and Lakshmi, even if not going so easily to Radhika, Radha Thakurani also. I'm telling you one story to finish this. So one day in Braj, Lalita Devi making some garland and flower crown, making and breaking. Narada Sri told, oh Lalita Devi, why are you doing all these things, making and breaking? Because I have not proper measurement. So I thought really proper. Then I think, oh, other day I took maybe little bigger, little smaller. I am making for Krishna. And this is seeing pastime coming on. Seeing is there. Seeing pastime. So natural, I can call Krishna here. Then you can take proper measurement and decorate. Oh, yes, that's a good idea. So Krishna Narasimha went to Krishna and called him. Lalita eagerly waiting for you to decorate you. Krishna came, put in seeing and Lalita decorating very nicely. And now told, oh Krishna, I have one desire. Then you will be seeing pastime with Lalita. No problem, very good. And telling this, Lalita and Krishna was both are singing, and Samsok is singing very nice song. And Radhika was ready to come, but her sok is decorating herself very nicely, so become little delay. In the meantime, Narada went to Barsana and told Radhika, oh, you think Krishna is most beloved, Krishna loves you so much, more than any other sakis, I don't believe this. Then Radhika told, oh Narada, how you are telling this? Well, yes, I have seen by own eyes, Krishna is doing singing pastime with Lalita. What? Well, yes. I told Krishna with a little bit, though I don't care for Radha. I want to be with Lalita. But really, yes. But if you want, you can go, you can see your own eyes. Radhika little sulky and coming. And I said, I'll not go very close, I can show from a distance. And showing, look, go ahead and look what is going on in these groves. Radhika seeing this, coming back and became very angry. And beating his feet on the earth very strongly. And Krishna, what happened? Radhika was coming, why running? And became very angry. Krishna came out from the swing and checked Radhika's. Why are you so angry? Radhika, not speaking, don't talk with me. Go to Lalita. Why coming to me? Then Krishna, are you in the trap of Narad? That fellow? Don't come in his trap. Radhika told, don't try to console me. I have seen my own eyes. Then Krishna told that Narada called me this and that. He's doing everything and told me. And maybe he informed you. How Lalita be without you? He's always respecting you, doing all arrangement, meeting with me and between you. How became angry with her? Then Lalita, Radhika understood this is due to Narada Rishi. Then she came and Lalita put her on the swing and looked, swing past her, everything took place. So Narada not allow anyone to go so easily. This is his duty, occupation duty. So then I'm coming back to my subject matter again. Then Lakshmi held a meeting with Parvati Devi and Savitri Devi. Yes, Narada told this thing. Okay. What to do? Somehow or other have to break her chastity. How being mortal world, material world, and any mortal person will be more chaste than us? Okay, someone tell more chaste than Savitri, Parvati, more chaste than Parvati, and no problem. Anyone be more chaste than Lakshmi? We could not tolerate this thing. What to do? Then Lakshmi told, we have to ask our husband to go there and break her chastity. Okay, when Narayan came, Lakshmi told this, Parvati told to Shivji and Savitri told to Brahmaji. They told, no, we will not go to break her chastity. He's a very great devotee. And it mentioned in scripture, Narinam Rodanam Balam. If ladies, the wife could not control their husband, they will begin to eat. And told, we will take poison. When Lakshmi told to Narayan and Gayatri, Savitri told to Brahmaji, Parvati told to Shivji, all became decide what to do now. And they'll do hunger strike. I'm not telling the devotees this. I think you are not telling your husband.
This Satyu friend is coming to the Kali Yuga too still?
Everywhere. Yeah. Maybe it happened for you also, Sarvaji.
It's a trend coming down the same way.
Then they went. The Chitrakut, mountain Chitrakut and Mandakini flowing there. And Otti Anusya, they are doing bhajan side by side, two hut. Brahmaji, Shivji and Narayan came in disguise of Brahmin and told Bhikchang Dehi, Bhikchang Dehi. Anusya Devi came with, she had some roots and some fruits to give the Brahmins. And then so many has come, so has come to give bhiksha. This is duty of householder. The assembly person came in, Brahmin had to give some bhiksha, some dakshina. That Brahmin told, oh, I don't like these alms. What you like? That the Brahmins told, he have to give bhiksha being completely disrobed. What? So many came. They never told, I have to give alms being completely disrobed. What is possible? And if any bhikshu, any beggar came to your house and you are not giving bhiksha, if they go without bhiksha, then your all auspiciousness will go with him or them. Anusha told, oh Brahman Devata, I have to take permission from my husband. Because Satir Devata Pati Jivaner Sar Pujite Sachi Bhave Charantamar. Just ladies there and husband is devotee, then you honor her husband first, then to God, because he is devotee. If devotee and husband both please, then God bound to please, because husband, not only husband, he is a devotee husband. I have to take permission from my husband. She went, and Otrisi, hearing this, closed eyes and began to smile. Then she told, Prabhu, why are you smiling? Well, yes, no problem. They are not ordinary Brahman. Being completely disrupt, we can give owls, they are Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh, no problem. Then she told her, yes, I am coming back, complete this job, I will give Diksha to you all, don't worry. And Anushya Devi went inside to take off his cloth, and Atri Rishi took some water, recited some mantra and told, Prakit Sisu Bhabhuva, and throw the water, means, please be like a newborn baby immediate. And now Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, now became newborn baby. If mother being complete disrobed, no one is there, took her child and give her breast milk, what harm? If other will see, then the matter of shyness. No one is there. When she came out, so they had no Brahmin, only three small baby, like just newborn baby. She took the baby, giving her breast milk. So much milk is coming, they are sucking breast milk. They are very happy. Now she again dressed herself. Atri she came. Now Anushya told, now we have to bring some, like to put the baby, what is called? That's not palanquin. Basa, like in yes, palna in Hindi. Yeah. Cradle. Cradle. They got three cradle. And keep that now, Atri Anushya became very happy. Now they are doing all these things, they are feeding them, they are very happy. Now, what to do now? So many days have been passed. Brahmaji is not there, Siddhi is not there, Narayan is not there. So one day Naradashi is going and Lakshmi is calling, Oh Narad Thakur. Narad knowingly not going there. They are calling, What happened? Then Naradashi told, oh, why calling? Well, he told, so I sent our husbands, they did not come back. Well, this is a very matter of very regret. I cannot tell my own tongue. And going, no, we have to. Well, I have not so much time. Then Lakshmi called Parvati and Savitri both. They came and told what happened. Now they told this is the fact. Well, I told, don't think that you are the best chest. What happened, look? And how to get them back? Then Narada told, oh, what shall I give you suggestion? Now they are not in full form, they are not baby form. The one thing you can do, you have to go in disguise of Brahmani, have to beg some alms. And when they want to give some alms, you ask, we don't want this fruit or root, I want these alms. By this you can get back, there's no other way. Then they went in disguise of Brahmani, but if there is fire, you may hide it with some ashes, but still heat will come. You could not check that, stop the heat. So they went, Bhikchang Dehi. Then what? Who came? And so Anushya Devi came to give Bhikcha. Then Anushya Devi brought some, oh, I don't want this. Then Anushya said, as before, some Brahmin came and they told, three Brahmins came and they told, we don't want this with this type. Some Brahmani came asking, we don't want this picture. Then Anushya asking, who are you? What is your identification? What you want? Then they told, we are your daughter-in-laws. Anushya, my daughter-in-laws? No. Then she understood. No, I will not marry my sons yet. My son is too small, you are too big, I did not be compatible, did not match, I will not do this. So what will you do? Anushya Devi told, let my sons grow enough, then I will choose my own daughter-in-law, I will not marry with you all this, I don't like. Then they began to, oh Devi, please excuse us. Due to us, this happened like this. We will not do any more. We think material world no one which is more than us. So now we get good lesson. Then Atri Rishi also came. Then Atri said, what can I do? If my wife give his children, her children, I have no problem. I cannot do anything. Anushya then told, I can do one thing. By one form, they will be my always eternal baby. I will notice them. In other form, they can go to abode of like Vaikuntha and Kailas and Brahmalok, they can go back their own abode. So there became their son. From Brahmaji became Chandrama, from Shivji became Durvasa, and from Narayan became Dattatreya. So when Durvasa told, oh, let me go to my father's abode. So Durvasa went to Shivlok. Shiv told, no, my dear son, I could not give you any shelter today. The big danger. So then he looked, Durvasa, oh, he's coming, chasing me. And Ambarish was constantly praying, oh, Sudarshan Chakra, please don't kill this Brahmin. So he told, look, who is in behind you will burn me and you both, father and son. So I cannot give you shelter. Then he went to Vishnu. Vishnu told, I am sorry, I could not help you today. Durvasa said, why not? I am a Brahmin and your pranam mantra is there. Namo Brahmanna Devaya, Go Brahmanna Hitaya Cha, Jagat Hitaya Krishnaya, Govindaya Namo Namo. You are Brahmanna Dev. You respect Brahmins and you give shelter to Brahmins. And today, why not giving shelter to me? Other hand, you are not the protector of Kshatriyas. You are taking side of Kshatriya. You are taking side of Brahmin. Bhagavan is telling, I am not taking shelter of anyone. My quality is bhakta vatsal. Like parents, they love their children. Even the children is handicapped, blind, and other children, more beautiful, more attractive, still parents will love their own children, not to other children. May love, but not as love as well as equal to their own children. It's not possible. So what to do now? And Durvasa telling, why taking the side of the Kshatriya? I am Brahmarshi, I am Brahman dynasty. Your the occupation will you to protect me. Then Bhagavan is telling, Aham Bhakta Paradhino. I am although supreme independent, but I am completely controlled by devotee. You are Brahmin and Brahmarshi, no doubt. But he is my devotee. So I control by him completely. And was telling, Vasi Kurvanti Pade Nittam Satriyo Satpatim Jatha. Just like one chest lady control her husband completely. In the same way, Bhagavan says, I am controlled completely by devotee. And then Vishnu giving example, if you stuck any thorn in your feet, it will not come out from your head. You have to operate from here and take the thorn out. In the same way, devotee, my lotus feet. You did offense lotus feet of my devotee. If you want, you have to go immediate to again material world, ask forgiveness from Ambarish Maharaj. Then you explain, otherwise my Sudarshan Chakra will not help you. So he came back to Ambarish Maharaj and asked forgiveness. And Ambarish Maharaj asked forgiveness. And told, oh, Durvasa, due to me you have to suffer so much, please excuse me. It takes about 1 year and Ambarish are not eating anything. Now question may arise, in 1 year Ambarish Maharaj maintained Ekadasi or not? Yes, he maintained. Gurudev told, yes, he maintained Ekadasi. Every day full fasting and next day doing Charanamrit. By this way he maintained his Ekadasi and pardon. Then when each other asked forgiveness, then Ambarish Maharaj freed him and then he took some prasad. Then Durvasa told, Aho Ananda Dasanam Prabhava Dadrishtami. Oh, now today I understood the glory of devotee. And before I have no idea, the devotee is so nice, so beautiful, so compassionate, so merciful, so sympathetic, I not know as before. So today I understood the glory of Krishna's devotee. When Brahmaji, Shivji, even Vishnu himself helping them and controlled completely by them. So if someone doing bhajan, even in the beginning, all the demigods make some disturbance, but later even Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh all help him. Mm-hmm. So whoever maintain Ekadasi, observe Ekadasi nicely, they will get bhakti. Even Brahmaji, Shivji and Vishnu all will be favorable to him and bestow their mercy. So everybody have to maintain Ekadasi. Then one day they can go to abode of Krishna and sat there very nicely, the divine couple, Hare Krishna. Vancha kalpataru bhasya kipa sindhu bhaye vacha patitanang pavane bho vaishnave bho namo namaha. Any question, please?
Mixing ekadashi, one with dasami and one with dadashi.
Ekadashi two types, because sometimes tithi overlapping, underlapping. When ekadashi tithi mixed with dasami called vidhya ekadashi, Vaishnavas should not maintain vidhya ekadashi. When ekadashi mixed with dadashi tithi next day, no problem, no harm. Vaishnavas will maintain ekadashi mixed with dadashi, not with dasami.
So, but if it's vidha, then we follow on 11th day. But if it's mixed with the 10th day, then
we... When you mixed with 10th day called vidha ekadashi or impure ekadashi, you should not maintain, not observe that day. Even next day, not pure ekadashi mixed with dadashi tithi, we observe ekadashi that day. Is favorable for bhakti.
But sometimes ekadashi is mixed with dasami and dvadashi.
No. Sometimes it happens, but very rare. Then you'll do.
Dvadashi.
Yes.
That's called Suddha
ekadashi. Yes.
It just happened recently.
Then the Mahadadashi will be there. Then will be Mahadadashi. Yeah. Mahadadashi is more powerful than pure ekadashi even.
It's all available on Google.
Yes.
We always
check. Any other question, please? Yes?
Alright, you said that simple activities take shelter in the brains.
Yes.
Please elaborate on that.
It mentioned in scripture, in the day of Ekadasi, all kind of sin, like to killing father, killing mother, killing Brahmins, killing cow, especially killing Brahmin and killing cow, the greatest sin in the whole world called Brahmahatta Pap. So, all sinful activity took shelter that day in grain. So, whoever take grain in that day, they are taking all sin inside their stomach, in their heart. I'm giving one example from Puran. There's one Brahmin, very wealthy Brahmin, and he has a very nice garden. So, one day, one cow entered his garden, and Brahmin had the nature of cows, animals, they graze here and there. This was some portion of garden. The Brahmin became very angry, took one bamboo and beat, cow died. Now, the sin, personified sin of Brahmahatta came to attack Brahmin. Brahmin said, don't touch me. Why not? You beat and kill the cow. You may beat, why kill the cow? So I have to possess you. Then Brahman told, do you know, we have all senses, there is one presiding deity, demigods, like for eyes, Surya is presiding deity of eyes, for tongue, Varun Dev, for hand, Indra Dev. Well, yes, I know that. Well, so, I beat the cow and send him the cow death by my hand. So, the predominating deity of hand is Indra. Go to Indra to catch him. No problem. That sin, Brahmahatta sin, went to heavenly planet Indra Lok. Want to embrace Indra. What? Why came to me? Like, because the Brahmin killed the cow. This is called Brahmahatta Pap. The sin of Brahmahatta. Brahmin and cow same. Indra told, okay, you can come with me. Indra came in mortal world and moving that garden and praising, oh, this so nice garden. Who did this garden? Who is this owner? He must be very qualified. I have never seen so nice garden in my whole life. And this is a Brahmin, he is praising. Hearing this, the Brahmin became very popped up. Oh, somebody is praising me so much. Brahmin came, oh, I am the owner of this garden. Oh, you are so nice, beautifully decorated everywhere. I never seen garden whole life, it's so nice. Then Brahman taking tour, here this, here this, there. And where the cow, he want to bypass. Narjula, what is there? Why not going this area? Let cover this area also. Then he told, oh, how come one cow is dead here? Then, oh, is due to his mischief activity. Then what happened? You kill this cow? Well, actually not by me, because I beat by hand with a big stick. So deity of hand is Indra. So this is due to fault of Indra. Then Indra told, okay, this is very good answer. I never knew this answer. Then Indra, you owner of this garden because you did by your own hand? Well, no. Only she will go to Indra, not Indra, you owner of this garden. Then Indra came in his own form and told Sin, now grab him. Then grab him. So he's showing all sinful activity. This is a very dangerous sin to kill Brahmin and kill cow. Almost no doubt to kill Vaishnav also. Must more sin. They all take shelter in the grain, it mentioned in scripture. So Ekadasi day or any Vishnu Tithi means when the appearance day of like Lord Krishna, Lord Mahaprabhu, Lord Ram, Lord Nityananda, Gaudam, Vaishnav will not take grain because all sins are there. And not only that, sometimes Guru Dev told that moon, he attracts water from the grain. You will see, if you do some survey in a big hospital, from Ekadasi to full moon, Ekadasi new moon, patient died more than other time. Anyone can survey and check this.
Ekadasi on a full moon?
From Ekadasi to full moon and Ekadasi to new moon.
They're more likely to bleed to death because the moon is pulling the water.
Pulling water from the body. So you can see in survey in hospital, rate of death in that time. Highest death. Other time also they are giving the body the highest rate of death during full moon, Ekadasi to full moon and Ekadasi to new moon.
Maharaji, in our West countries here, particularly because one of my friend's wife, she's working and reaching to the mental people, they told whenever the full moon day comes, they not allowed anybody to take a day off. They want that they should be in the hospital. And they had find out the activities of these people go more higher, right? They go
yeah, all this is increase.
Yeah. Only on the full moon.
Yeah, full moon.
Police, I get shot when I
police also.
They put more staff.
Same with criminal activity.
Criminal activity. Yeah.
And they have more birds on
more wet.
That I don't know about.
Are they getting full moon?
More birds in your garden. More birds.
Birds.
The moon is pulling them out.
Maharaj, you're describing glories of prasad, and you show glorifying prasad, and also you mentioned Mahaprabhu's pastime, glorifying the quality of the prasad is all our spiritual.
Yes.
When prasad is offered, the sinful tendency within the grain, does it remain? And that's why we don't take grain on Ekadasi, even though it may be.
No, prasad. When you're offering, any sinful cannot stay there. But
prasadam is
always chinmay. But devotee, because he's made of grain, so Bhagavan prohibit himself not to take. We have to honor Bhagavan's order, our Guru Varga's order of Vedas, we have to follow that.
So then in the context of prasad, the reason why we don't take grain is different than
yes.
Material.
Yes. Okay, Mahamantra.
Jai Jai Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai Radha Ramana
Hari Govinda Jai Jai
Jai Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai Jai
Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jai
Jai Govinda Jai Jai
Govinda Jai Jai
Govinda Jai Jai
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare
Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Hare
Rama,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama 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 Rama,
Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare
Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
What is tomorrow's program?
Tomorrow's program is a fire defense and I'm going to be invited. Everybody needs any address to let you know.
rest of all the people move by. My one Prabhu has already written my address in.
Anyone needs it, you can give that.
If you can hit the 88 all the way down. 88, yeah. And come down to after the Scott Road, right?
Yeah.
128, 160, after the 112, there is a lights of Shepherd lights. Take a right turn on the Shepherd light. And first, again, you have to take a right turn. And then the left is the Russell right, and second one is my house.
Can you take them up the schedule?
Yeah.